On a Tuesday when we met, I got to know on the Wednesday that a few matters appeared in the press, and they specifically relate to me. I would want to address this matter so that nobody is under any illusions what the issues are. So those of you of the press, it's good that you disseminate information, you let the world know what is happening, because clearly without you, I mean, the rest of the world wouldn't know what is going on. But I also expect that by undertaking your job, you have a very serious responsibility to present the facts as they are. Skewing matters don't help anybody. And sometimes too, I think it is incumbent on you to read the language of the speaker right and present it accurately to the public. Two instances I would want to address. I was reported, maybe wrongly, on the front pages of a lot of papers a couple of weeks back that I said I was fighting at the garage, the filling station. The word I used was that a third world war almost broke out. When you reported it, you forgot that I wasn't a street fighter. You said I almost fought. But that was because I was complaining that prices of petroleum products that had been hiked so much that it affected everybody. And I'd gone there to buy and to pay, and I felt the pain, and I told the whole world. Maybe to the credit of Joy, they just opposed the two, what I was supposed to have said the last time and what you reported that I said yesterday, on the Tuesday. On the Tuesday, I did not make any such categorical pronouncement as to whether I buy fuel or I don't. You should be able to distinguish various segments of what anybody speaks. Any sentence should be able to be broken down to its minutiae to be clear what a person is saying. Our colleague, the minority leader, Haruna Idris, asked a rhetorical question if Ghanaians or those of us in the room were buying or were not buying fuel. So I said sarcastically that, well, I wasn't buying fuel because I didn't have a car. Since when did that become news? I would have thought that clearly somebody, funny enough, my colleague here, Sami, was clear in his mind. He said to me, I bet you they will pick up this and make a story out of it. Look at him nodding his head. He said, yeah, because he said it. I said to him, Sami, why would they say, do that? He said, I know they will do it. And that's unfair. When I've gone out there and told the whole world that I buy fuel and we do this, I made that comment, and it's all over the place. Joy was, well, the KT Jamon said this the last time. Today he said the witches will dance, he or he doesn't. That wasn't that bad. But the other papers and the other ones are making an emphatic statement that he says he doesn't buy. Well, let's get it on record. Members of parliament buy fuel. We don't have any coupons. We don't have rebates. We don't have anything. We're suffering the same way every Ghanaian is suffering. We appreciate it. It's been put on record many times. We all know what is going on. It's not a matter that anybody is running away from. We are all in it together. How we get out of it is also in the hands of all of us. Let's get the reportage fairly right. Now, what is upsetting me, though, it's not so much about this. It's about your tricks, about your recordings and the cameras and whatever, the kind of things that you do. Well, for those of you who don't know, I am capable of independent thinking and intelligent articulations of my independent views. For somebody to have thought that somebody in the public gallery was in a position to influence my questioning and my thinking of the day, and to say that it is atrocious and unfair. It's patronizing. It's insulting my intelligence. I mean, if you recall, just when it all started, I switched on my phones. The next moment along the line, 1 minute, I'll finish in a minute. This is important to me. Let me put it on record. The next moment, a matter came up. But I had a quick recollection that I think I know about this matter. So I quickly opened my phone, had a good look at it, and then made a comment. I wasn't making an allegation. I was making a comment reflecting what had been sent to me. We make our own independent research. We're entitled to do that. I had, on the 6th of November, been sent a message from America explaining that there had been a bond attracting the issues that I raised on that day. It struck me that that was there, and I wanted to bring it up for my colleague Ato to discuss. Somehow, I'm later told that somebody in there was flashing some phone, whatever, and was directing me. And you positioned this like that. You could see that a person was angling towards me, and I was quickly reading something. And so it was somebody detecting to Katie Hammond's brains. Ghana Web has the effrontery to write that immediately after that, Katie Hammond was then asking critical questions of Ato Forson. That's completely unfair, and you do me outrageous injustice. I require an apology from you. Thank you very much.